All right, we're back. This is the B7TA Honda automatic transmission teardown. In this video, we're going to show you how to take apart the valve body and look for problems and see what's going on with this transmission. So far, we got bunt up clutches. Now we're getting into the valve body. All right, first up, take a differential, set it out of the way. Take this darn spring off right here. And this spring right here, and this shifter, you can take it off anytime you want to. You can take it out when you're getting the darn clutches off. Take it, sit to the side. Take a 10 socket. It don't have to be an impact gun. Here's your 1-2 accumulator. Take all these bolts out right here, except for one right on the edge. Jiggle it. Darn dowel pins holding it a little bit. Comes right up. The reason you don't take that one bolt out on the edge, you got two check balls in there. What I like doing is, every valve body I take apart is, I always like to check the valves in them. Wait a minute. Well, here's your problem right here. One of your problems. When I first took this transmission apart, I noticed the gasket right here is black. From the factory, these gaskets are not black, they're green. From every Honda transmission that I know of, from 90 to 2020, they come from the factory green. Sometimes you might see one is red. Somebody's been in this transmission before, and they left the valve out right here. This is your loop valve, but it also helps it darn applied the clutches. So after we get everything apart, we're gonna take these springs out in here and see what of them's red or green. They might have put a shift kit in it, but if they did put a shift kit in it, it ain't working right. So we're gonna set that right there for now. Go to the next one. This right here is your pressure regulator valve body. This one's very important. Same process, just jiggle it and lift up. Sorry about that, guys. I'm just... And there's your other problem right here. So this transmission has been in before. Somebody didn't build it right. Or something. This little valve right here. This is your check valve for your torque converter. And yes, it's supposed to bounce up and down. But when I first took it up, it was stuck down. When it's stuck down, you ain't getting all the fluids to your torque converter. This thing will be pumping all day. It can pump and pump and pump, but that torque converter will just keep on pumping back out, back into the pan. So that right there was sticking. See here. In here somewhere. And the other thing they left out, looks like, is the check ball. We're going to tear it down the rest of the way. I believe we are missing the check ball that goes in there. Everyone I've ever seen had a check ball right here, and it is not there. Dump all these darn bolts out right here. Keep all your bolts together, each bad body you take apart. What I like to do is I keep the feed pipes in them. You can take them out, but I like to keep them in there. I don't like hunting them down. Right here, you got a little filter. If you have a delay going from reverse to park or park to drive, these filters in the valve body, they get clogged up. When they get clogged up, your valve body's starving from fluid, so it's going to be a delay. Let me see if I can get it out for you. Here we go. So you hold it up to the light. This one's pretty clean. The rebuild kit you get, some of them come with them, some of them don't. If they don't come, you can clean them and put them back in. It's basically your filter. You turn this over, you check this valve right here. This shift valve C, shift valve A. When they move freely like that, there's nothing wrong with them. Here's your pressure regulator valve. If it gets stuck, you have a problem, but it does move. It's going to be a lot of pressure on it. That one's good right there. Alright, Zach, keeping all my bolts back right where I got them from. These darn dowel pins. Do not lose these dowel pins. You'll never get the darn thing lined up right. Alright. Take this little piece out right here. Sometimes they slide right out easy. Check your little gasket right here, little seal. Rebuild kits come with that. Take this little pin out. Stick it right there. Stick that separator plate right there. Now, here we are. Sorry about that, guys. This thing, my light above me is messing up. Our little check bar we was looking for is right here. And it's actually stuck. I just popped it out of the hole. You got a little check ball and a little spring. So, if that check ball gets stuck, it will cause it from shifting funny. Take that little check ball. All that do is, I stick it right there in the hole. That thing was rolling off the table. Alright, next. Come over here to your servo valve body. Here's your 3-4 accumulator. Take these springs out, make sure they ain't busted. If they are broke, replace them. I'll get it later on. And dock. But the only thing might be in Texas by now. Like I said, try to keep all your bolts together. Jiggle it, lift up. Sometimes the plate will get stuck on it. Dump it out a little bit. Now I got your little servo shifter. That darn thing's flat. Rebuild kits come with that. Turn upside down, check your valves again. Got one right here. That one's free. Got one right here. You gotta look real close. Some of these valves will be tricky on you. That one's free. That one's real free. That one is too. If you get a stuck valve, we might make a video later on of how you take the valves out and clean them. But that is time consuming. Time to keep this video short for you. All your bolts right here to the side. Get a separator. Alright, here comes the fun part. Here's a little filter right here. There's a little filter. It's clean too. This shows me somebody's been in this transmission before. Here's the torque of the check valve. It finally broke free. And somebody has been in it before. That spring is a whole lot harder. That's the shift kit they put in it. Slide your manual lever out. Check it for screwing. Got a little bit right there, a little Scotch Brite fix that. Alright, party time. Got a 10 there. Switch over to your 12. Bear with me, guys. It's been a long day. It's time to make videos for y'all. Alright, take your fingers. Lift it real easy. These valve bodies are all very expensive. If you break them, they are $700. Some of them are. All I do is I just take it, dump it out. Just dump it out like that. Stand up on its side like here and turn it over. We're gonna look real close. And I believe they did put a shift kit in it. Whoever built this transmission put a shift kit in it. They put bigger valves in it right here and here. This is your torque converter charge valve right here. Real big. It's very free. That one's free right there. That one's free. That one right here is kind of stuck. That's your second clutch, second and third clutch valve almost right there. And this valve right here is stuck. So if I can get a little pick to get that go down in there. We got one valve that's stuck. So we pretty much found out what's wrong with this transmission. Somebody's been it before, they didn't quite build it right. You get it stuck there, that valve will not move. Look at this valve over here. This valve right here, that valve right here moves like it's nothing. This one right here, that one right here moves. You go right here, this valve supposed to move, and it will not move. So, it's stuck completely. Oh, got it move a little bit. It's light. So, we'll take that valve out later and clean it. So, take your valve body, sit it right here to the side, keep your bolts together to it. Right here's your pump gills. Take that out, make sure it's all good and clean. No screwing, this is what you're talking about, the pumps. This is what you're talking about, tons to pump the fluid. Take this out, check it for scrolling. This one right here, they look real good. On this one, make sure the groove side is facing down. If it's upside down, first time you crank it, you will blow stuff up in it. Alright. Now the rest of the mess continues. We pretty much got the whole valve body apart. I'm just showing you this, the separator plate that's heat treated. And there we are. Basically, look down here. When you're cleaning these things, All these pads just gotta be cleaned. Everything, all this real thick metal. So something came loose in it. That might be part of that valve. That valve might have popped out, went down and got grinded up, as far as we know. Seen it happen before. But there we are. This was part two of the B7TA Honda Odyssey transmission rebuild. Well, tail down, my bad. Very long day. Please like and subscribe my videos. And if you like what you see, I will continue to tail some more down. And I'm going to try to get some rebuild videos up shortly. Waiting on parts for a 4-cylinder transmission. And parts for this one should be here tomorrow. And we might rebuild this one tomorrow, maybe. So, if you like my videos, please like and subscribe. I'm new at making videos, so please look over my stuttering, or if you don't see something I'm saying it right, please look over that as I get better at making videos. Thank you and have a good day.